the grandmother and the whole family here. South Africa, ladies and gentlemen, a big applause.
Welcome to the second edition of Speed Zone. We're at the Junior World Championship in Heerde in Holland, and today's edition is called Rainbow Nation. The reason for that is we're surrounded by all South Africans, every one of them qualified, and then of course Shannon Terreblanche, South Africa's GP rider, or one of South Africa's GP riders, is here as a spectator still recovering. We'll introduce the riders. This is Shannon Terreblanche next to me. And then we have Aaron Maria from Port Elizabeth, Calvin Vlaanderen also from Port Elizabeth, and Grant Frerichs from
Cape Town.
Oh, Calvin is from Cape Town, sorry. All right, we'll start about, we'll edit that part out. We'll start with Shannon. Shannon, just briefly, we spoke to you a while ago, and we spoke about the injury. Just a quick update, how's it coming with the injury?
Yeah, it was going really good up until now, you know. I had no pain or anything, but I had an operation on my knee because I damaged it 2 or 3 weeks before I broke my femur. And it was a small operation, only to fix my meniscus, and also I had a bit of scar tissue on above my knee, and it was going into the joint, and it was preventing me from moving it, you know. And it wasn't such a big operation, but it hurts so bad, it's crazy. But I hope I can get well soon, you know, and just start training again so that I can come back strong.
All right, it wasn't so long ago that you yourself were at the Junior World Championships in Latvia. And unlike the countryman here, you had to go to the last chance qualifying session. Now looking at this today as a spectator, does it bring back any memories for you?
Yeah, I remember when I came to Europe the first time, you know, and I went to the Junior World Championship. It was amazing, the feeling that, like, just coming here and knowing that you're going to be riding against the world's best junior riders, you know. And I was really surprised with these guys. They rode really good, and for them to come and just qualify straight out on the time training is really, really good. And people in South Africa, and yeah, people in Europe understand it, but in South Africa they don't understand what it means, you know. And I think they accomplished something that's really, really good.
All right, now Aaron next to me. Aaron, you come from Port Elizabeth. Of course, there's a sand track there, but nowhere near all this. What did you expect coming into here, and how did you find it? How was it for you at the end of the day?
I thought that there are going to be lots of ruts and stuff, which I started practice in PE. I knew it was going to be rough. I didn't think it would be as heavy as it was. The soil is like really heavy and like slows you down. And it was hard to ride, but it's copable.
All right, and you qualified really well. You were in and out, and they dropped you down the list, and then you put at the last minute, you put the lap and brought you back into 15th, and then finally dropped to 16th. When you finished the lap, did you feel that you had it?
I didn't really know, because I didn't know I dropped out, and then the last lap Shannon just told me to be smooth, so I tried to do one of those laps and got me into 15th.
All right, that's great. Well, now Calvin, you're from Cape Town. Also, you have a little bit of experience of sand, and, but it's still a little bit different from here. Is this your first international race, first of all?
No, I went to go race the international race in Namibia, I think in 2003.
All right, and you were, of course, this is a new experience for South Africans. There's a really, really deep sand in the heart of Holland against some of the best sand riders in the world. What did you expect coming into the race?
No, I trained quite hard. I expected really rough tracks, and I expected the guys to be really fast. My goal was just to qualify.
All right, then. And what's your expectations for tomorrow now?
I'm just trying to do my best.
All right. All right, let's hop over to Grant. Grant is probably, for him, it would have been the hardest, because you come from an area of hard tracks, so not so used to the sand. The first session was a little bit difficult, and then it smoothed out to the second session, and then the lap came, and you were in. Did you know that was the lap?
I had a feeling that it was going to be that lap. You know, it all came together at the beginning part. I made a few mistakes, but I managed to hold it. So.
And of course, you've been to Europe a few times, or you've been to Europe and you have a bit of experience, but I don't think something like this in a race or in qualifying against such opposition in such deep sand. When you came over here, what did you expect, or where did your hopes lie?
The last time I didn't get to ride that much because I crashed a week after getting here and dislocated my elbow. but I expected it to be sandy. I managed to find a sand track at home so I could practice there, but it was nothing like this. This just holds you, and it's so different, you have to get used to it. Like every week it just gets better and better.
All right. Now, Shannon, if you looked at the guys now, you see now they've done, you know now the first hard job is done. So now tomorrow it's the thing of the race. How would you tell them to approach the race then tomorrow?
Yeah, for sure they're gonna be nervous, you know? It's racing against the world's best junior riders, and like, I'd say just try and go out there. You guys have qualified already. That's one of the biggest things, you know? Just go out there and ride as smooth as you can and just take it easy. People in the sand, when they come to the sand, they tend to try and ride too hard and bash the berms and just like out of control, you know, and that makes you tired. And like after a couple of laps, you're tired and you just go way off the pace, you know? So you just want to try and stay smooth and just be smooth through the corners, keep momentum and just take this as a learning experience more than and putting pressure on yourself to like really do good, you know?
All right, now, Aaron, I know that there are plans for you to come over maybe next year to Europe to come and race here. Do you have any idea what the plans are, what races you'd want to do, what championships and so on?
I don't really know. I'm hoping that we come over here, and I don't know where I'll be staying, but I think I'll be racing the Belofton class in the 250 until I turn 15, then I'll be able to ride the national class. I don't know what championships we'd be doing. Most probably the Belgian championships.
All right, and your ultimate dream, of course, there's a whole heap of South Africans that's come. It's in recent times you've had Grant and on the tail of that, Tyler, Wyatt, Gareth Swanepoel. Now Shannon is here. Looking at all of that, what do you hope to achieve in Europe?
Well, I hope to eventually get to GPs, and then eventually we'll hopefully turn the world championship.
All right, great. Calvin, your province is probably the least known motocross province. Okay, we forget about the Free State. But motocross is mostly strong in Natal and in KwaZulu-Natal in Gauteng. So you guys have a bit of a disadvantage. What do you do to get across that?
Well, I just try my best, and I do all that I can to try and get here and to be as fast as all the other people in South Africa. And
Are there plans for you also to come to Europe eventually?
I might come next year just to do a little race or something, and then because I'm 12 now, I just need to get a little bit older.
All right. That's really amazing to qualify for a Junior World Championship at 12. All right, and then finally, Grant, I know you guys are also looking at other things, possibility of a German race. Maybe even next weekend you're going to ride in the Kayevel in Belgium next weekend. And for you, the future plans in Europe?
Yeah, I first have to get past school. Parents are very tight to school. So we'll see. Maybe next year try to come over here again during holidays, see if we can maybe get a ride or something. We're off to take a gap here and see what happens.
All right. Okay, guys, that's it for today, and good luck tomorrow. Then, thanks.
I see you.
Yeah, you're walking in the street.
It's a chromophone, you know.
I thought that. Thanks. Congratulations, there. May I have a big cheer for us? Perfect, mother.